How's it going, everyone? It is Punk here, and welcome back to WWE 2K16 Universe Mode. So, I was gonna show you last episode the teams I had, but I forgot. I'm a forgetful person. But anyway, I want to show you real quick who I have. We obviously have Austin and Baylor as the NXT champ, or not NXT, as the World Tag Team Champions for SmackDown. Fit Finlay and Booker T are the tag champs for Raw. And then we have the Shield 2.0. Roman Reigns, Jack Swagger, and Heath Slater. And then we have the Hollywood Blondes, Ziggler and Stunning Steve Austin. Vicious and Delicious. I don't know why they're named that. They're such a random team, so I figured let's just put a random name for them. So, here's Evolution for SmackDown. Triple H and Ric Flair wanted to create newer stars once again, and they thought Kevin Owens and Cesaro were the guys. And then we have the Ministry of Darkness with Connor and Victor and The Undertaker. Then we have the Legacy from Raw, Randy Orton, Curtis Axel, and Big E. These were all randomized, by the way, so except these ones. I believe it. So these are the ones that I did. From Austin and Baylor to the Legacy. So, so all together, it's pretty even with the tag division, like how many people are fighting for it. Four tag teams, and then four here. So, it's pretty good. Let's get to Raw. Oh, yeah, then this match. Freaking awesome match. Alright, so let's go to Raw. Now, wait. Before I do, I just want to make sure there's five matches on Raw. Because I do not want to go through what I went through last time. Alright, there's five matches. Good. Oh! Jimmy Uso versus William Regal. Okay. So, alright. Oh, it's a false count anywhere, too. So, let's get right into it. Jimmy Uso versus William Regal. Now, this isn't the William Regal that's with Hideo Itami. The one that's with Hideo Itami is Lord Steven Regal. So, I honestly don't know what made Triple H want to book this match, but we're in Montreal, Canada tonight. Hope we see Sami Zayn. Oh, wait, no, he's on SmackDown. Here comes Jimmy Uso.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring. From San
He's
Francisco,
very excited.
California,
He's like, I'm finally on Raw. It's only the second Jimmy episode, though, so Uso. You'll probably be on plenty more.
You can feel the intensity level inside the arena rising.
If this thing was a popularity contest, this guy would have already won. Good thing it's not, though. This is the WWE, and he's going to have to earn his victories.
Yeah, but, you know, it's nice to be liked.
Crowd's going Uso crazy, Michael. I just spilled a whole bunch of Pepsi on me. Okay. Jimmy Uso definitely ready. And he's very excited to compete in front of Montreal, Canada. There are my buddies once again, Michael Cole, JBL, and Jerry the King Lawler. And here he comes, William Regal, who for some reason still has black hair.
And approaching the ring, from Blackpool, England, weighing in at 243 pounds, William Regal!
Man, the passion this crowd has for this superstar is truly amazing. Just listen to him.
It's no mystery that the Raw audience has been waiting to see this one for a while now.
It kind of sucks. William Regal never became like a world champion in WWE. Because I think he deserves it, you know. At least he did. Because I'm telling you, I believe it was like 2008 when he was like King of the Ring and Intercontinental Champion. I hated him then. So, I mean, he was a pretty good heel in my opinion, but I like him now. He's the general manager for NXT. That doesn't exist
Welcome
in this universe
and
mode.
Thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Michael
now
Cole,
they both lock up.
the Hall of Famer.
Jimmy Uso. Jerry the King Lawler. Looks like to be in full strength right now.
This might well be one of the most
referee now pulling Jimmy Uso out of the way.
Absolutely, Michael. This one's going to be great.
Oh. Uso. Oh, well, Regal reverses it, though. Now going after Jimmy's arm. It's not the arms they need to go after. It's the legs. You know, with that superfly splash and the super kick from the Usos. From Jimmy. So, if I was Regal, I'd be going after the legs. That's a smart thing to do. Excuse me, now Regal. Clothesline by Jimmy Uso.
And the tie-up, make no mistake about it. This is all about skill, determination, and power.
And we're watching human gridlock
now Regal
here.
In control.
No one will budge.
And now here's Jimmy
Uso. Uso now, back in control.
You know, there are a few guys in this business tougher than William Regal. Here's a guy who began his career competing in carnivals all over England when he was just a teenager.
Ooh, I mean, Uso now. Nice. Nice move by Jimmy Uso. Stomping on William Regal. Oh, and Regal went out of the ring. Regal running back in the ring. Uh-oh. Oh, Regal reversed it to a DDT. A nice DDT. That looks like it hurt. Regal now. Oh, knees Jimmy right in the face. That had to hurt. Uh-oh. Regal. Could this make Jimmy tap? Could William Regal win right now? Oh, no. Regal looks like he let go. Punches Jimmy Uso. Oh, my knees him again right in the face. Regal in control of the match. And just as I say that, Jimmy Uso is in control as he goes outside to the ring. It is a false count anywhere match, so weapons are allowed.
Yeah, and of course, between WCW and WWE, William Regal has been
incredibly
successful here in the United States.
Oh! Uso hit the ref. The ref no-sold it, though.
WWE King of the Ring in 2008.
Ooh! Regal kicked. Oh yeah, speaking of King of the Ring, after this, after Extreme Rules, King of the Ring is actually coming up. So, we're going to be crowning a new King of the Ring.
So,
ooh, Regal kicks.
Uh-oh,
look at Uso. Jimmy Uso now in control right now. Uh-oh, oh!
I guess he's done with that.
Uh-oh.
Move. Yeah, but what's he going to do next?
Now look at Jimmy.
You know what I like about
Russian leg sweep.
No wasted movement when he competes. He comes right at you with his unique
Uso now picking William
offense.
Regal up.
He doesn't waste any time or energy trying to
throwing him to oath to the barricade as he flips. Nice.
Oh God, that was hitting the nail right on the head. If he takes many more
Jimmy
moves,
in full control right now. Oh, it looked like he was going for something, but Regal was able to get to him on time. Uh-oh. Regal has those steel steps. This is going to hurt. Oh, man. Oh, my God. Oh, that is not pretty. William Regal just going after Jimmy. Oh, Jimmy went through the... They both seem a little confused. Oh, man. William Regal now.
If you're not paying attention,
that using the steel steps definitely helped.
Yeah,
William Regal.
Regal's incredible pure wrestling ability.
And now look at him.
So many different ways he can beat you, whether it's with a submission move or.
Oh my God! William Regal. Oh! I thought that was it. I thought that was it. Jimmy Uso somehow kicked out. How in the world did that happen? Oh, Jimmy Uso might have I am so surprised Jimmy Uso can even stand. I mean, oh, as he throws Regal to the barricade, but Regal back in control. Throwing him to the barricade. Ooh, head first. And now Regal going for the pin. This could be it. Oh, but Jimmy kicks out.
Nice. It's going to take more than that to keep him
down. Ooh, Uso went out of the way. Regal. Oh, but Regal's right back in control. Uh-oh. Went for some punch, but Uso countered. And Regal going for a Russian leg sweep, reversing Jimmy's move. Oh, an elbow drop. As Riho goes for the pin. One, two, three. William Regal won the match. Definitely back and forth between the two. Uso is in pretty in control for the beginning of the match, and William Regal just in control at the end. What a match these two had.
One in a million is the only way to describe this match.
Once Regal got a hold of those stairs, I mean, Uso just had no chance. I mean, that was just the end. And I thought this was the end. Holy crap.
You want to talk about crowd pleasing?
Here it is. Or not the whole thing, but this is where Uso got face first into the barricade.
That match was
incredible. Here it is. I believe this is the replay of the ending, where he goes for a Russian leg sweep. Oh no, then he went for the elbow drop, and that's where it ended.
Here's your winner, William Regal.
Put a check in the win column for William Regal.
There's nothing more appealing than picking up a win in a good old-fashioned 101 fight.
Join us again next week for WWE Raw.
All right, let's go to the next match. Brie Bella versus Paige. Nice. I'm liking this. So far, rivalries have been a lot better this year.
Oh,
Tamina from behind attacks Brie Bella. Remember last week, Brie Bella lost to... Brie Bella won. Tamina lost, getting some revenge. Is this a little an alliance here? Paige and Tamina. Brie Bella thrown into the ring. Paige in full control. The match hasn't even really started yet. And the match has officially started. Brie might lose just because of that attack from Tamina. Oh, but Brie now has some fight left in her. Kicks Paige right in the back.
And so taking a look at Brie Bella, any thoughts come to mind?
Definitely.
Can Brie Bella fight back from this? Can Brie Bella somehow pick up a win? Now that, in my opinion, would be an upset, knowing that Tamina attacked Brie from behind. And right now, Brie's just in full control.
Brie Bella is conjuring up some good momentum here.
Now Brie has Paige in a headlock.
Here's a girl in Paige that was told she wasn't pretty enough to be a WWE diva.
What?
And that she needed to change who she was. She needed
really
to
has
like else.
Paige in a
and
headlock.
You know what she did?
As she finally releases
she
it.
She just went about her business, determined Ooh. To become the best diva in the business, and look at her now.
A yeah, kick to a DDT, a nice DDT, I might add.
She went out on her own at age 14 and traveled all over the world.
And now, oh, nice reversal by Paige. And look at Paige.
You name it, she's been there.
Will Brie tap to this submission hold?
Taking over this contest. And there's the release.
Oh,
what's
I think Paige released
now?
It.
I'm scared to ask. No.
Ooh.
Nice reversal.
Uh-oh. Now Paige, she's in control right now. What does Paige have in mind? Uh-oh.
We're seeing two outstanding athletes looking to prove their dominance.
Whoa! Nice!
Walk out victorious.
This could be it already. Oh no, but Paige is not done. That might have been it for Brie, but Brie has some fight left in her still. Uh-oh, Paige now throwing Brie outside to the ring as Paige goes out as well.
WWE Divas title simultaneously.
Oh man, that had to hurt. Brie just twisting. Or Paige twisting Brie's head. Wanted to say. Now, Paige picking Brie up, punching Brie in the face.
Smile
missed a chop, throws Bree back in the ring, elbows her in the head. Paige now back in the ring, lifting Bree up, but Bree reverses it. And now Bree lifting Paige up. Oh, went for a kick, but missed. And now Paige. Oh, man. A little voice crack right there. Paige now. Oh, going for the submission hold once again. Could this make Bree tap? Oh, but Bree still does not tap out. She never gives up. Just like what her sister's boyfriend says, never give up. Now Bree getting hit by Paige on the arm, going after the arms. And now Paige, oh, Bree reversed it into a neck breaker.
Look at the attack here. Oh man, talk about a direct.
Ooh, Paige reverses by a kick. Ooh, drop kick. A drop kick by Paige now. Ooh, kicks her right in the head. That had her hurt. Uh-oh, you know what's coming next.
WWE programming when Brie Bella debuted with her twin sister Nikki.
Uh-oh, here it goes. Oh, man.
Paige delivers the pain in an astonishing
Paige
fashion, folks.
With her finisher, that has to be it. Oh, yeah, it is. Isn't her finisher like the Rampage or something? I can't remember what it's called. But Paige gets the win.
Look who's come out here,
now,
Michael.
Tamina is out here telling Brie she wants that title. She saw what Stephanie did to Cameron, and she wanted to do the same thing. Alrighty, let's go to the next match. Match number 3. Oh wait, Tamina viciously attacked champion Brie Bella before the match began. 3 more weeks until the conclusion of the rivalry. Brie's status thing went down. Okay. So let's look at the next match. Alright, Paul White versus Heath Slater. Rematch from last week. Heath Slater, part of the Shield, won that match. We did not watch it because I simulated it. But here comes Paul White, our U.S. champion. And like I said on that small belt would never fit Big Show. Excuse me, Paul White.
From Tampa, Florida, weighing in at 425 pounds, the United States champion, Paul White.
Oh boy, we're in for a treat tonight. Both of these superstars look geared up and ready to go.
I can't wait to see what happens when the bell rings and these two finally get to go at each other.
Big Show looks ready. I hope he studied Heath Slater's matches. Huge upset last week when Heath Slater defeated. When Heath Slater defeated the Big Show, Paul White. Big Show's on SmackDown. He's counting down to him lifting his hand up. Everyone looks forward to that. Big Show looks ready, but he does not look happy. And when, when Paul White's not happy, that is not good news. And here comes Heath Slater. And I know you can't hear it, but he's coming out to the Shield theme.
And approaching the ring, representing the Shield. From Pine
what the hell?
Virginia,
He should be wearing his Shield outfit.
Heath Slater.
And now here's Heath Slater. Watch out. The one-man band is on his way. You know, this guy can sing like a bird. Okay, a vulture. Well, for this guy's sake, it's a good thing crowd reaction has absolutely nothing to do with the outcome of the match.
Heath Slater forgot to wear his Shield outfit. I believe Jack Swagger and Roman Reigns will be pretty pissed off about that. But this match will have to continue anyway. I guess Heath Slater wanted to wear his Rock Band tights one last time before he goes into full Shield mode. Maybe he just feels like these tights are good luck. I have no idea. But here we go. Paul White versus Heath Slater is now underway. Will Heath Slater once again defeat Paul White? Or will Paul White finally beat Heath Slater? Slater's fading fast here. Big Show lifting Heath up and slamming him down. That person wants one of them to throw him a shirt, but they were not wearing shirts when they came out. At least I'm pretty sure they weren't. Ooh, Big Show going at Paul White, excuse me, going after the arm. And now has him in a little. Oh, Heath reversed it.
What are your thoughts on Paul White?
A ton of talent, a ton of ability.
And now Heath,
someone to keep an eye on.
Looks to be in control right now. Oh, as Paul White throws Heath. Now look at Heath. Oh man, it looked like he was about to lift Paul White up, but oh, Paul White hits a suplex on Heath Slater. Now, oh, Heath reversed with a headbutt now. Ooh, what a chop, what a punch, and a dropkick, and that big man's down. Heath Slater is in control right now. Oh, knees Paul White right in the face. Oh, Paul White now. Paul White in control right now. Just stomping on Heath Slater. Ooh, hitting Heath right in the back, and now, ooh, slamming his head on the mat. And Paul White lifting Heath up. Oh, but Heath reverses into an uppercut. Look at Heath now. Oh, he chops Paul White. Ooh. Paul White, surprisingly, is not in control. Huge upset last week, but Heath Slater just knows what he's doing. He has definitely studied his work. He knew what he had to do when fighting Paul White as he goes for a flatliner. I am just shocked right now. And look at Heath now.
Oh no.
Ooh.
What's he gonna do here?
I believe that's, is that the backward DDT, reverse DDT, something like that. Ooh! Heath Slater knees Big Show right in the face as he goes for a pin. One, two. Oh, but Paul White kicks out. Kicks out at two.
Steamroller on top of Paul White to keep him down. Man, Heath Slater is wrecking his opponent right now.
Yeah, Jerry Lawler's right. Heath Slater is in control. He is dominating his opponent right now. And now Heath turns him around. Oh!
And Slater sneaks it in.
This could be it. One, two. Oh, but Paul White kicks out at two. And Heath could not believe it. Heath is shocked right now as both men are up and Paul White went to do something but missed. And now Heath Slater goes for a Russian leg sweep. Everyone just loves to do that in this universe mode. Now Heath Slater. Oh! What is he doing with our announce table? Taking our monitors down.
You never know what'll happen next.
What does he have in mind? Oh, right to the side of the announce table. Heath Slater. I think I know what he wants to do, and I am not too excited about it. Oh my God, Heath. What are you going to do?
Oh, I don't like this.
Oh my. Oh my God, DDT right through the table. Oh my God, this could be it. He lifts Big Show up and runs in the ring. What? Heath Slater cannot believe what he just did.
Back into the ring now.
He could have won by count out. He could have won as he goes for a drop kick. Heath Slater does not know what to do running around the ring. Oh, what a drop kick once again by Heath Slater. Why isn't he, I don't know, I don't understand why he's not going for the pin. Oh, Big Show, Paul White lifts Heath Slater up now. Oh, look at the strength of Paul White. Oh man, that had to hurt. Heath Slater should have had this one. But stupid mistakes right now are keeping him from this win. Overdrive.
The last thing
He's going for the pin now. One, two, three. Heath Slater. Oh, my God. He defeated Paul White, the United States champion, 2 weeks in a row. Holy moly. This is just mind-blowing. 2 weeks in a row, the U.S. champ Paul White has lost to Heath Slater.
Well, I don't know how you can pick out highlights from that match. The whole match was highlights.
Wow. That was a very shocking match, I'd say. Heath Slater in control the majority of that match. Could we be seeing this at Extreme Rules, ladies and gentlemen? Could Heath Slater be our next United States champion? And can he bring a title home for the Shield 2.0? Look at this beautiful DDT on the announce table. And for some reason, I think he wanted to bring him back in the ring. But he didn't want to be counted out as well. And this is the ending right here where he goes for the overdrive. There's a president of the Heath Slater fan club. But anyway, Heath Slater goes for the pin as he won the match. Huge win for Heath Slater.
Here's your winner, representing the Shield, Heath Slater.
There's no doubt about it. That's a big pinfall win right there.
Impressive doesn't even begin to describe his performance here tonight.
This
Michael.
Is just that surprising. He is. He is.
And it looks to me like our winner is already thinking about the next match. Always one step ahead.
You know, Paul White won't be happy. All righty, ladies and gentlemen, let's go to the next match. I believe the next match is the main event. Let's see, what other matches did we have? We had that one, the Divas one. Oh, no, so this will be the fourth match we're watching. Oh, crap! Seth Rollins, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion against Neville. And there's something that you don't know about Neville, but he is the Million Dollar Champion. The Million Dollar Man believes in him. Both men are already in the ring. Wait a minute.
Is that?
We hear Chris. There's Christian.
Look who's coming out.
Christian is out here.
But it looks like he's got a bone to pick with one of the superstars.
Yeah, and he doesn't look too happy to see him.
Christian
either.
Is the number one contender for Seth Rollins' world champion. He's going to sit at ringside with us.
Did you hear the trash talk between them? I don't think he's going to stay focused in this match.
I wonder what Christian has in mind in being out here. I wish he was in the commentary, but he's just going to sit right next to us. As this match is getting underway.
Yeah, too bad he's not in the mood.
Two amazing competitors fighting in this ring. Neville versus Seth Rollins. World Heavyweight Champion.
Collar and elbow
and Million Dollar Champion.
This is critical for a competitor in establishing themselves in the match.
Here we
now
go.
Seth.
With
Seth. Ooh.
Rollins.
Seth in control right now. Oh, just punches Neville right in the face.
Looking fresh right now, which is good.
Look
you
at these two.
Wonder how much longer that can last, though.
Seth now has Neville in the corner as the ref tells Seth to go out. Oh, nails Neville right in the head.
Seems like these guys are letting out a lot of pent-up frustration.
Now tied up once
tonight.
Again. Seth Rollins with the headlock.
And now it's Seth Rollins.
Throws him
momentum.
To the ground. Now Neville. Oh, Rollins just throws him back into the ground. Now picks him up and slams him down.
These two never
beautiful.
Cease to entertain the WWE Universe.
Oh, Neville reversing with a kick to the head. Ooh, another kick. Another kick. Here comes Neville. Ooh, nails him right in the head. No wonder why the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, chose this guy to be the Million Dollar Champion. Oh, Seth now.
Look out.
Uh-oh. Oh, my God.
On the back of his head.
That was on the back of his head. That did not look pretty at all. As Neville now reversing it.
He's
ooh.
Just playing classic offense here.
Yeah, and that's when he's the most dangerous.
And here comes... Oh, no. Seth reverses it. You know, you always have to... You know, since your number one contender is outside the ring, you always have to have that in the back of your mind. What if Christian gets involved in this match? You know, I mean, he may distract Seth and Neville may win this. I mean, Seth has a lot of pressure right now. Now Rollins lifting Neville up. Oh, going for a roll. Oh, no, not going. Oh, what a kick to the head. Beautiful. As he goes for the pin now.
Looking to catch him off guard. Quick rip. And he
escapes. As Neville kicks out. Kicks out at two. Uh-oh.
Hard Irish whip into the corner.
See, Seth, he's getting distracted by Christian.
Uh-oh. Our guest is getting a little restless here.
Uh-oh. What are they going to do now?
Between these two superstars. Over some unresolved issues.
Oh, but look at Neville from behind. Nail Seth right in the face. I told you, a distraction like that could change the matchup. Christian now. Christian's leaving now. Seth is, or is Neville going after the legs.
Have a second to breathe when he's in the ring.
Oh, but Seth throws Neville in the ring. That distraction could have cost. Oh, it could have cost Seth Rollins, but I mean, it doesn't look. Oh, Seth seems to be in control right as of now.
And Rollins with the reversal.
That little distraction. I mean, you just never know. Oh, but look at Neville reversing with a fireman's carry. And now look at Neville with a diamond cutter.
Never performing in a WWE.
Whoa! Holy crap! What a move by Neville as he goes for the pin. One, two, oh! Seth barely kicks out at two, and Neville can't believe it. I can't believe it either. I thought that was it.
I sure as heck did.
Oh, but look at Ron. Oh, wait, Neville. Neville with a roll-up. Neville with a roll-up. This could be it. One, two, oh! Rollins barely kicked out again. What a matchup between these two.
Uh-oh. That may be the first time we've seen that executed.
What a matchup between these two. I am very impressed. Oh, but look at Rollins. Look at Rollins. Oh, Enziguri.
At least it looks like it.
And now Seth. Oh, he gets kicked by a Neville. And now Neville lifts Seth up.
They're not dreaming. This snapmare is for real. What a move.
Oh, has Rollins in a headlock now.
He's pulling out all the stops.
Owen Rollins. He's reversing it.
Just making his presence felt there.
What a
oh, look at Rollins. Ooh.
That is not a position you want to be
and now
in.
Now Rollins with the headlock.
In this match or ever.
No, not again.
That's
Neville now.
Cutting off oxygen inflicts serious damage to an opponent. Hey, you could have until the referee's five count to break it.
Ooh, Neville now. Looks like he's in control. As he throws Seth into the turnbuckle. Oh, but Seth kicks him. Look at Rollins. Oh, what a neck breaker. As he stomps on Neville. Oh, Rollins. Oh, look at Neville. Going for the pin. One, two. Oh, but Rollins kicks out. What a matchup between both champions. Neville running to the ropes for no reason.
Oh,
Seth! Oh no, but Neville now back in control just like that. Oh, but Seth reverses it. Whatever Neville had in mind, it's going to have to wait. Because Rollins... Oh, Rollins has Neville upside down on the turnbuckle and kicks him. Rollins is just tormenting his opponent right now. Uh-oh, what does he have? Oh, my God. Oh, man! What a stomp! Now Rollins.
You can practically feel the wear.
Rollins was, I think he was going for something, but he decided not to. Oh, and look at Seth.
He's in big trouble.
Oh,
he's gonna be out of his
man,
mind.
Did that again. Oh, that had to hurt. Oh, and look at Seth showing right off. Not just taking his time now right with now. Neville.
Wow. Unbelievable impact.
I think
there.
Seth believes he has Neville beat.
Not today,
oh, but look
fast.
At Neville. Never, never think you can, never think you can beat Neville just like that as the ref goes for the, oh, Seth barely kicked out. I don't know why Seth would be so cocky when Seth nearly lost a match three times
man,
already.
Oh,
like Rollins back now back in control.
Watching. Yeah, one of those you never want to see in.
Seth is twisting the head of Neville.
I just can't
Rollins now
the
going to the outside of the ring.
Brutal, brutal and very, very painful.
Looks like he just wants
guys.
To take a little breather. What's Rollins doing? Is Rollins? Rollins is seriously walking out. He is walking
tonight.
Out of this
it
match.
Doesn't get much better than this.
Rollins has decided he doesn't even want to bother with Neville. But Neville is just walking behind Seth.
Oh, he missed.
Oh, and Neville, he gets Seth with a, oh, Seth reverses though.
Man, Seth Rollins, what
but look at, oh, but Neville running to
the ring. Is survival. The
I believe he believes
when you get near all these
Seth is following him. Seth Rollins has decided he does not want to continue this match.
And now it is show-off time. Don't waste time gloating here.
Looks like Neville's going to be winning by count-out. I can't believe this.
And again, the mind games are played. With all that build-up, it's sad to see
the million-dollar champion Neville wins the match, but not the way he wanted to.
Competitors tore this arena apart.
Terrific match, but Seth Rollins at the end just decided he wanted to leave. Maybe he just felt like he couldn't beat Neville. He thought he had it all, but every time he thinks he has something going for him, Neville just finds a new way to ruin it for
incredible.
Him. I think that's why Seth wanted to leave. What a match between these two men. Neville definitely deserves to be a number one contender in the future against Rollins. I'm just shocked that Rollins would just leave the match like
that. In this match.
And there it is. I thought that was when he was walking out, but there was so many times where Rollins looked like he was about
highlights.
To lose. I guess he didn't want to be embarrassed by losing by an actual pinfall or submission, so he just decided to walk out of that match by countout. Neville obviously not happy, not thrilled with that ending.
Here's your winner,
but a win's a win, isn't it?
Neville!
What an incredible match. That one could have gone either way. Nobody has anything to be ashamed of in this one.
Yeah, you're right. It's just a shame that someone had to lose.
That's the kind of win that makes
crowd
you feel good about yourself.
Going nuts with Neville.
Thank you again for joining us tonight as we come to you live from historic Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
We're not in Pittsburgh, Michael. We're in Montreal, Canada. You're an idiot. We're not in Pittsburgh. It said that we were in Montreal, Canada the first time. Every match we went, except this one, because they didn't show entrances, it said we were in Montreal, Canada, you dork. Ugh. Alrighty, here we go. It is now time for the main event. Intensity is building between champion Seth Rollins and Christian after their confrontation. 3 more weeks until the conclusion of the rivalry. Alright. Cowardly went up. Desperate and disrespectful and egotistical went down. Neville's respectful and bold went up. Alrighty. So, this is the main event. What do you think it's going to be? Okay. Okay. Brock Lesnar, John Cena, Xavier Woods, and Triple H. A fatal four-way match in the main event. Triple H probably saw that Stephanie had one hell of a main event for SmackDown. So he wanted to top it. He knew how good, he knew how well Brock Lesnar and Xavier Woods went. So he wanted to put them in this match. Then he wanted to put himself in the match. And then he wanted to put John Cena in the match because so many kids love him. Everybody's going to tune in. Smart thinking by Triple H.
Like it or not, John Cena is unquestionably the face of WWE.
That's right. In every arena we go to, we hear passionate fan responses from both sides of the fence. You know, week in and week out, this guy gets one of the biggest reactions of the night.
John Cena last week defeating Macho Man Randy Savage, a surprising victory. Well, surprising and not surprising, but... Could Cena pull it off in this match? Could he be the winner of this fatal four-way match? Cena looks ready. He looks fired up. And here comes Xavier Woods.
Superstar has all the tools needed to win this one. Now let's see if he can put them together.
I imagine fans will be talking about this Raw match for years to come.
Xavier Woods losing to Brock Lesnar last week in an amazing match. First match of the night last week for the Universe Mode. I mean, I was not expecting Xavier to have as much offense as he did against Lesnar, but he did not win it. So I'm assuming Xavier would want to win this match. And if he could beat Brock, that would be much better for him. And here comes the beast, Brock Lesnar. And look at the crowd.
And from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 200.
Dancing around, he's ready.
With Brock Lesnar, this one has the ability to turn ugly very fast.
You know, why would anyone want to sign on to face Brock Lesnar is beyond me. Well, they're jam-packed to the rafters here in Pittsburgh in anticipation for this one.
I mean, okay, I wasn't paying attention, but when Cena came out, did it say Montreal or Pittsburgh? Because I'm pretty sure we're in Montreal tonight. Jerry Lawler, Michael Cole, you are big idiots. Thank God I'm here. Look at Xavier. Oh, no, Xavier's leaving now. I was about to say, he's not even afraid of Lesnar. All three men are waiting for the GM, Triple H, to come out. Triple H wanted to book himself in this match because they are all huge stars for his show, Monday Night Raw. Alrighty. I just wonder how SmackDown is going to return. Because last week, Raw had a triple threat match. That was the worst, most boring match I've ever seen. And then Stephanie was like, hey, I'm gonna have a triple threat match that people will enjoy. And it was definitely the match of the night. Now Triple H wanted this fatal four-way. I wonder what Stephanie will have in mind for her tonight. Or for SmackDown. Lesnar looks ready to go up against Triple H. And Triple H looks freaking ready. Look at him. left it broken and dead. Bow down to the, bow down to the king. I really have no clue who's going to win this match. I mean, sure, this is Triple H's first match on Monday Night Raw for the 2K16 Universe Mode. Cena winning last week, Lesnar won last week, Xavier losing, but he looks very good going into this match. He showed a lot of strength last week against Lesnar. So I wouldn't be surprised if he won, but he's definitely not the person I'd assume would win this match, because he's also competing against three of the greats. Triple H telling everybody to bow down to him, the King of Kings, as we are all ready for this fatal four-way match. John Cena, Xavier Woods, Brock Lesnar, and the game, King of Kings, the GM of Raw, Triple H.
And here we go.
Oh, look at Lesnar taking Triple H to Suplex City already. And Xavier going after the other blue guy, John Cena. Oh, and Lesnar with an armbar. With an armbar on the GM. I don't think that's a smart move exactly. Oh, and Lesnar breaking. He's taking Xavier Woods to Suplex City as well. And look at Cena. Oh, and Triple H has a sledgehammer. Is this a no disqualification match? I didn't pay attention when I looked.
Someone who has all the talent necessary to become one of the all.
And Cena now throwing Lesnar to the outside. Cena outside the ring. Xavier Woods going after Triple H inside the ring.
Turning that around.
Xavier now throwing, Irish whipping Triple H.
Ooh. Woods is in control.
Xavier Woods is in control of this match. That's something Jerry Lawler said, right? Oh, as Triple H with a fireman's carry. Now has a sledgehammer. This does not look good for Xavier. Oh, and I'm right in the butt. Oh, going after the legs. And as Lesnar and Cena are fighting to the outside, right near the barricade, right near the fans. Oh, look at Cena now. Ooh. Now Xavier at the turnbuckle. Getting Irish whipped to the other turnbuckle as he just Triple H hits a clothesline on him. Now Cena. Ooh!
I assure you that hurts.
So much action. I wish we had more people to call it. Look at Xavier. Oh, and Cena. Just brutally beating Lesnar up. And Xavier in control of this against Triple H.
I think jumping straight into the deep end.
Oh, man, does he have that arm submission? Xavier elbowing Triple H's head. Oh, and DDT. What a beautiful DDT right there. As Xavier goes for the pin, could this be it? Two. Oh, but Triple H kicks out. And Cena and Lesnar back in the ring. But Cena throws Lesnar right outside the ring again. Xavier tries to hit Cena, but Triple H. Oh, nice reversal by Triple H. And Triple H goes for the pin. Could this be it? One, two. Oh, no, but Triple H does not get the three. Xavier kicks out at two. Now Triple H has that sledgehammer. Oh, and he hits Xavier right in the stomach. That had to hurt. Triple H missing. And Xavier now. Oh, and look at Xavier with his little jabs. And, oh, the final jab. This, could this be it? Crowd chanting Cena. Definitely a Cena crowd here tonight. Pretty shocked to hear that. Xavier Woods and Triple H and Cena and Lesnar all on the outside of the ring fighting, but I don't think this is a false count anywhere. You have to pin your opponent inside the ring. Oh, Xavier hitting the ring. Now Cena still in control, beating up Lesnar, punching him. as he throws Lesnar into the barricade. Owen and Xavier hits the ring once again. Benchmark in John Cena's career. Lesnar's busted open. Owen, look at Cena. Oh, Lesnar hits the step stunner,
giving the champ an attitude adjustment from the top of a 16-foot ladder just before.
Owen and Xavier once again hits the ladder. Cena in full control of Lesnar right now. Triple H just keeps throwing Lesnar, or keeps throwing Xavier into the ring. Oh, I believe he hits the steps that time. Xavier now finally reversing it, throwing Triple H to the barricade. Oh no. Oh my God! Head first! Head first on the steps! Now Lesnar throws Cena to the steel steps at her. And Xavier now Russian leg sweep. Look at Lesnar throwing Cena back in the ring. But he's still a superstar. Lesnar and Cena back in the ring. Xavier and Triple H still on the outside. Cena in control right now.
When it comes to the tables, ladders, and chairs. And John Cena's never had any shortage of creativity.
Now Cena going to the outside.
Outside the ring. Whatever
object going after
use,
the other
use,
blue man, Xavier.
He can find, John Cena's going to find it.
Throwing Xavier back in the ring. Oh, Lesnar. Now all the men are in the ring as Lesnar takes... Wow! What in the world? Holy crap, Xavier! What in the world? What in the world did Xavier... Oh, crap! Lesnar hits the F5 on Xavier Woods! He hits the F5 on Xavier! The move that ended Xavier last week could possibly end him this week.
Thank you for spending your money.
Cena and Triple H on the outside. Cena didn't realize, but Lesnar just picked up the win. Triple H is not having it. He is not happy about that result. He wanted to win that match. I hope they show the replay of Xavier. Holy crap. Once again, a nice match between all four men. Xavier in control a lot during the match against Triple H.
And look at the impact in these highlights.
It just, the power of positivity does not seem to be working all that well, because he's 0-2. Lesnar, 2-0. What a match between all four guys.
Those WWE competitors,
we do not get to see that beautiful replay. But we do get to see Lesnar beating Xavier Woods. And you just saw a little bit ago Cena and Triple H. Cena did not realize that Lesnar hit the F5 and got the win.
Here's your winner.
Guys, that was a big win for him right there. You know you're for real when you can outlast three of the baddest guys on the WWE roster.
Thank you again for joining us tonight as we come to you live from historic Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Montreal!
Hall of Famer Bruno Sammartino.
Brock Lesnar busted open with an amazing fight right here. Well, ladies and gentlemen, from Montreal, Canada, like it where we were. From Montreal, Canada, we say good night.